What is up, everyone? Panzerlane here with Hearts of Iron 4. We're trying to switch the world over to, or we're trying to switch our armies over to Space Marines in order to conquer the world. So that is that. That is what we're doing. We're just slowly switching our dudes over and hoping things turn out well. So there we go. I'm keeping an eye on how many. Let's not do that. Although, let's not open the console commands. Although, I would like to just, kill everyone now, or get rid of all of the bad guys. So it looks like that we got ourselves down to two super heavy tank destroyers. Let's kind of cool our jets right now, because we will, struggle to keep them supplied and all that. And you say you're ready to go. Why? What's your problem? Where are you? Where's this guy? Oh, well, you're supposed to be right there. Yeah, stay there. So, that is that. I mean, they're not exactly going to do that much in Switzerland. I mean, the mountains are going to be terrible. But, I mean, we didn't nuke all of this, so, not exactly the best. We'll let it recover. It should recover. So, okay, it looks like we only have 12 units. Okay, so there we go. Here is the next army of Space Marines. But we'll let them. We'll, like, put out a separate army for them. So, how is our cavalry doing? Are they, like, actually garrisoning everything? Yeah, y'all aren't doing a terrible job. Are some of y'all stuck in the ocean? They like, oh no, they're moving for the most part, I think. I hope. Please. That'd be nice. So, yeah. And we have 500 air experience yet again. Okay, let's figure out what airplanes we want to improve. I think let's just improve the fighters even more. So reliability is. Yeah, I don't want to take the reliability. Honestly, we'll just leave it. See, that's the thing. Like, I wish you could. Like, I don't know. I don't know what I'm trying to say. Like, you can only improve so much of a fighter. Like, I wish you could just make it all around better, slowly but surely. Like, I know they want you to, like, eventually use your research to get better planes, but, like, I don't know. This game does great during World War II, but does not project post-war that well, as you can tell, 1948. So, that is that. How are you doing? So let's switch a guy over. Pretty sure we have enough by now. 28 available, so we can switch two technically. So there's a one. There's a two. There we go. Boom shakalaka. Okay, so there's that. Good for us. So we'll get these guys switched, and we'll put them up here. We'll get these guys switched, and we'll put them up here. And then I think we can get a fourth army of Space Marines. But we'll probably just launch this attack with only three. Try and get through Europe, so try and get on the Soviet border, so like the Polish or like the East-West Poland border. I think that's what we have right here. Because this is, yep. Yeah, this is. If we just look at, yeah, Eastern Poland, Western Poland, we'll get up to that designation. Maybe push through Italy, and then maybe we'll use our fourth army to push through the Balkans. Because I do want to push through Turkey. Although, that would open up several different fronts, like Africa, Iran, and all that. We want to get the Soviet Union knocked out of the war, because they're the big bad wolf. They're the ones we got to take out. They're the big dogs. So apparently Luxembourg is the world power we have to take out, but we have to take out the Raj from the Allies, and then the Soviets. And once we take out the Soviets, then we'll see what other Comintern countries we need to attack. So let's check and see if we can switch one over now. Yep, we can. So there we go. Good for us. Switch them to here. Good thing. And we have so many nuclear weapons. I wish nukes actually did... If nukes actually did damage to troops, we would have won this war already. But then again, good thing nukes don't do damage to troops, because I would be overpowered. Could I? What's your problem? Large river crossing. Huh. So, yeah. So, we have a lot of troops. We could attack, but again, I want it to just be one mass assault. Excuse me, sweeping across Europe, and then just carry our momentum to conquer all of Eurasia and Africa too. Although Africa's colonies. Like, once we get there, we'll, you know, once we get things up and running. So next, so National South Africa, are you at war? You're at war with just South. You're at war with everyone, aren't you? Yeah. So, what are you doing? War goals. Oh, so yeah, the Civil War here. Although it appears that it's drawn up. Okay, so there is a war going on. There is a war going on. And poor National South Africa has, like, actually have to take them out. But if you ask me, I want normal South Africa. I want the democracy to win, but, you know, I want them to take casualties while they're at it. Speaking of, like, that, like, Turkey, are you going to switch over? Like, what about Iran? Like, is the Soviet Union looking bad, too? I don't know. Although, I might stage a coup in the Soviet Union. I'll stage coups in all these places. Let's do that. And let's do that over here. In Stalingrad? That'd be ironic. Let's stage a coup in Stalingrad. What about... So, Turkey, let's stage a coup as well. A fascist coup in Istanbul. That'd be hilarious. And then in Iran, let's stage a fascist coup in Kurdistan. Where else were we losing popular? Ooh, Australia. Let's do it. So let's stage a fascist coup in That's right, we have to do it in either Western Australia. Let's do it in the Northern Territories. Let's stage a bunch of coups. When will these happen? When will these happen? I want to find out. Because, let's see. Let's stage a coup. October. Some of, these will all finish in October of 1949 or August of 1950. Okay. That's interesting. Okay, well, whatever. We're staging communist or fascist coups to create civil wars and cause problems. So, that's good. And I'm pretty sure we would probably have enough super heavies right now. Yes, we do. So there we go. Put them into the training army. And do our thing. There we go. Boom shakalaka. And we'll just let them train up. We'll wait. We'll wait for them to train. We'll always have 24 guys in the training army. And yeah, we have one, two, three. We have basically two more infantry armies to switch over. And then, of course, we have to train them. So there's that. And we do have a deficit, which is a bit unfortunate. However, it is the way things are going. So it'll be over a year before these coups... before these queues hatch, so I don't know if we'll I don't know how fast we'll progress. We might not progress. This game just might be at a stalemate, which would definitely suck. But at that point, like, I don't know. I think the Louisiana Empire is pretty good, pretty well off. We'll play through it. But then at that case, I probably will switch this to like a victory lap, like. Upload schedule, so just one a week, so I can free a space for, like, you know, more substantial series. So, yeah. Where are you? Yep, okay. So, We're just waiting for these guys to get all trained up. And you know what? I don't know. I do not know. As a matter of fact, I almost just wanna. Although we do want to train them up because the bonuses, but also, yeah, we also need to pace ourselves in terms of production and in terms of production and like how many super heavies we can get. So there's that. That is definitely something to keep in mind. Free stuff. Yay. Okay, so let's. I mean, it already looks ugly as hell in France, but I also did want to do. Let's build more radar here in the Americas. So there we go. I do like the idea of radar all over the Caribbean. Gotta know when those hurricanes are coming. There we go. Got it. You know, this will be our like storm Doppler radar. Yeah. You know, except we're designed for bad guys. So let's just build radar all over the place. All kinds of radar. There we go. Okay. Boom shakalaka. So, how's this army coming? No one is yet where I want them to be. That is annoying. Okay. I'm gonna bring up another moderate complaint. The armies down here should be the same order as the armies on this tab up here. That seems logical to me. So, get paradox, get to it. Yes. So, I'm thinking long and hard about this. All right, so we have 18 guys. Let's switch you to Space Marine. Move you here. So, yeah. So, yeah. It's just the way things are going. We're trying to break a stalemate here, and it's tough because there's a lot of them and there's not as much of me. And the thing is, I could match them pound for pound, but then supply issues and all of that. So I just need to wear out their manpower. That's just the way it is. And hopefully train up my own troops. Let's go to speed 4. Or even speed 5. Let's go to speed 5. The game is gonna lag so hard. So let's switch these over one at a time. Just kidding. Yep. So let's watch these and just let them train. Let them train, let the coups, you know, infiltrate the other governments, take them over. Speaking of, is anyone boosting party pot? No one's even trying that. So you see, if I were in their situation, first off, I would be attacking. Second of all, I'd be offering non-aggression pacts. Nice try. Nice try, fascist South Africa, not falling for it. Then I'd be boosting party popularity. You know, I'm trying to. I think, you know, you just gotta try and generate that civil war. Pull the World War I Germany. Try and knock your opponent out with via a civil war. Like, that'd be big. So, there we go. Yes. What about now? There we go. So let's do that. Boom. And I don't want. Okay, so we got advanced anti-air. Good for us. Let's get the synthetic refinery because I don't care anymore. I just need stuff to research. Because I want to research stuff. So there we go. Advanced anti-air. Good for us. And we're chilling. So, we're training up our space marines, getting them ready to attack. We're going to put them along this red line and probably just have them go like this. Probably like, yeah, take like all the way up to here. And then this blue army will have them rethink their line, probably to the Soviet border. And then We'll probably have to split off units. One to go down and take Greece. One to go, like, secure. Although Istanbul is going to be the site of a coup. So, yeah, just take Greece. Although I don't think we're going to be there by the time the coup hatches. When is the Turkish coup gonna hatch? October of 1949. So yeah, that one's gonna be here any second now. It's gonna be a year, but that does seem quick. I could get jet fighters. I could get other stuff. Like, let's get super heavy battleships. Yay! Let's research boats I'm never gonna use. Woohoo. Yep. I'm feeling very cynical right now. And it's partially because the World War I mentality is getting to me. The whole we're stuck in a deadlock and like it's just not never gonna end. Like that's draining on me right now. Obviously, I don't have the responsibility of millions of soldiers, but I don't like this. This isn't something I did not expect to happen. So that there's that. There is that. I could try and come across the Pacific and mess with everyone, but that wouldn't be as fun. Hi, John Curtin. You're amazing in Civ, and you also look better in Civ. So that's that. This guy looks awesome. Michael Joseph Savage. He looks like a puppet, or like a ventriloquist doll. That's what he looks like. I'm sorry, New Zealanders and Aussies, for insulting your people, your leaders. I think they look cool, but I'm comparing them to. I call it like I see it. That's always how I roll. So, let's switch another one of these cats over. Space Marines. There we go. So let's switch you over to this. Yep. And eventually, one day, I will have enough, or they will be trained up enough to be put on the front lines. So, there's that. And yeah, increasing the combat width of your existing divisions is also a good way to boost your army size without having to train more divisions. Because, like, if you just have a lot of manpower, just increase your, combat width because. Then it's just, more oomph to your guys. More oomph. So yeah, we're just training our guys up. It's a bit boring, actually. So I might actually skip some time. I normally don't do this, but I'm gonna skip some time between episodes and make sure, get it all set up, and then I'll come back to you whenever it's time to launch the attack. Just to make this go quicker. So, nothing's happening. We're not at war with anyone. If we were fighting, I would do it that way. But anyways, thank you all so much for watching. This is Benjamin signing out, and I will see y'all next time. Later, y'all.